Hey y'all, well, just a joke of the day. This video has been up already, y'all, and it got blocked. I don't want to get into why there's a copyright law on it. And it's funny when you get, anybody ever got that, where you get blocked almost in every country, and it's hilarious. So it's blocked on YouTube, blocked here, supposedly for music rights. That's fine. So here's the joke of it, y'all. Some of these videos I'm putting up are already up. This already happened to me before. That's why I'm laughing. Some of these videos are already up with me talking over them about what dances in them go by on the timeline down, and it didn't get blocked. So, you know, it's just funny. Again, this is what y'all vote for. So always remember that. Let's have fun. I don't vote, so I just like to go around things. A lot of y'all who vote, you don't realize you actually keep in place these laws that enslave y'all when you vote. But since y'all vote, you're supporting the laws. Since you're not in the actual office able to write the laws, your votes don't matter. They don't. Who says they have to tell the truth? So like I said, y'all the ones that sit here voting. So the hilarious part is then, imagine y'all really believe in legal and illegal or immigrant status on the same planet. Y'all vote for that. Somebody can be a legal or illegal alien on the same planet. That's hilarious. And even crazier, how can y'all be immigrants? Because I hear some of y'all really retarded arguments. How can you be an immigrant alien on the same planet? How do you native or aboriginal to the same planet? It's a lie. Alien is supposed to be something that can't live where it's stationed, right? So if you're alien to the moon, you're not alien to the planet Earth. If your body can take the elements and can take the sun and the moon that comes on the Earth, you're not alien here. There's no such thing as an illegal immigrant. I've never seen grass come up and say, excuse me, where's your passport? Where's your ID? No, it's people who agree to make that illusion that do that. Let me tell you a really funny story. The colonized created labeled land called Hong Kong. I remember a friend had to get a supposed visa to go from Hong Kong to the colonized land labeled China. And there's only a iron railing between the two places. And when he was going to get it, I was already explaining this, how stupid it was. And all I was doing, the confirmation from nature was hilarious because there was a bird just jumping back and forth on what y'all call the border. I was a bird just jumping back and forth. And then it started flying back and forth from tree to tree. And then I started laughing. I told a friend of mine, where's that bird's passport? Because how can it just go back and forth like that? And you up here getting a visa. And he just looked at the floor. I said, come on, y'all. This is a nonsense y'all don't realize. If y'all don't realize it, then you realize it now. If you realize it before, I don't know why y'all vote. Because you're only reinstating the fact that you're becoming aliens to a place that you were created for. We're on an interesting, it's not new, but the internet is just a computer reflection of the system we're in. So for a lot of y'all don't realize, we're on record. Everything you put up here is recorded and can be used to another purpose. And supposedly, if y'all believe people are all equal, how are you getting the rights to be illegal or illegal from another human if you believe everybody's human? Come on, y'all. How are humans giving y'all rights and making laws over the bodies we've all been temporarily given that none of us own to tell us who can go where, what, and when? Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Y'all put that much power into another human, groups of humans, and then think that if there is some kind of higher power, creator, whatever, that y'all not going to suffer. Y'all look like y'all praising them, not that so-called creator or creators or nature or whatever. It's very weird. It's starting to seem like y'all are on this together. So when I looked at comments like that, that's what I tell people is that fake war. Like, there's so many people out here that don't have the gift, or they've been taken away from the gift they have, so they want to put hate on people that live the gift that they have. So they make comments like that. Like, legendary freestyle dancers in a choreography class. That's interesting. Yeah, so every time you see me do this, everybody in the business has what they call an industry face. That is an industry face. So don't forget that. So it's gonna parallel off of that, but don't forget. That was my industry face. Or, you know, it'd be more of a squint sometimes, or a lick of the lips or something. But everybody has their industry face. Some people go a little bit more drastic, but I'm not getting into that. But my industry face was more the eyes, right? Because people like the eyes. So, pay attention.
You're supposed to be out there doing freestyle and choreography. It's not supposed to be separate, because that's... I have to give a big round of applause to the person that kicked me in the club in 1987. And of course, I'm not going to know who you are. You might remember my face, I guess, because it's actually more similar now because I have less hair. And when I first went to the clubs, I had the little flat top and all that, but I did a long stint of just locks, and y'all see that. What's interesting is the person I was in the club, and for a lot of people don't know, when you go to the clubs back in the day, a lot of times people just go there just to hang out and have fun. You know, people were pushing me to be this protege and making me go on auditions, and I didn't want to go, you know, especially some of them, they would ask you to lie at like 10, 11 years old, and I couldn't lie because I was in a Christian school. So they were like, well, if the kid can't say he's 12 and he's really 10, we can't slate that. And I'm like, well, you're not slating it. And luckily, the greatest human on the planet would back me up. So right there, I knew something was wrong. Because like, why do I need to, you know, I never comprehended acting anyway. Like, why do I need to lie? Why do I need to pretend I'm something else? Like, already that's something children don't need to do. Because if you tell children don't pretend and don't lie, and then you're telling them to learn how to lie, is another contradiction. So moving on. I'm in the club just hanging out. All of a sudden I turn around because my thing was dancing in front of speakers. Now, yeah, a lot of y'all, yes, I did start off as a boogie boy, but I'll tell you this 100%, people came up to me to battle because I was always in the corner. You know, even when the boogie end was in, I would always be in the corner or the side of the circle watching people and just getting down on the side, just having fun, loving the music. Like you'll see, like you saw in that video, I had a striped shirt and I love to cheer people on. That's the love thing that I have a gift of. I just love to see gifted people dancing. Especially in that video, there were so many people gifted that in that video that were gifted. And rest in peace to Marjorie and Pabone. And my boy David, who's not dead, but you know, he's a DJ now. He was all great gifted dancers in that specific style. So when I saw a rerun, Fred Penguin Berry, rest in peace, as a child, that's really what I wanted to be into. Not the locking, the dance part. the locking is great, of course, too, or camber locking. But he was a dancer. It was different. I'm not going to explain that here, but I'll explain that in the book in 2024. That's when it's going to definitely come out because of a certain seance y'all all joining by then. So once that seance is over, the productive people will be left over. So the book is for the productive people. So I'm sitting there like, you know, wanting to do that as a kid. And then I saw Bojangles and all that as well, and all those other footages that I wanted to do all that. That was the dancing. So the person, the greatest human on the planet, was smart, though. She knew that the ballet technique was pretty much trying to take over the world. She knew it wasn't the only technique, so she was smart. She took me to ballet, took me to the THRU name should be contemporary jazz, and took me to African classes, and took me to tap classes all at the same time, and allowed me, when I was young, to see people on the street and dance with them in that style, what my brother was teaching me, what they call the boogie style. So already was deadly, the training. So when I go to the clubs, or I was to go to the park jams with my brother and all that, it was always, I would have fun. Always a battle would start because people saw me having too much fun. That's how a lot of people in the colonized, created label, poor, low-income, ghetto areas, they make jokes and all that, but they really don't want to see someone being truly an individual. And I was always individual. I never ran around with a lot of crews and all that. I was always individual, just up in a party doing me and somebody want to start something. So always would dance. Now, usually not fighting, because I'm not a person who likes to fight. And I never could comprehend when I was quote-unquote what they call pro-black or pro-non-white. I could never comprehend touching anybody this color. And so a lot of fights back in the day, people would start, and I'm saying a lot for me because I think I only had two or three fights. I wouldn't really swing back, or I would swing back wildly to make it look like I'm not a punk or something, but I never wanted to touch somebody my skin color. I found that to be the greatest entertainment. If someone believed in race, that's the greatest entertainment for white people, to see non-white people hurt non-white people. It's the greatest entertainment. Greatest. I'm in the club, chilling. It's about 87. It's easy to answer with that, with this war that ballet was always trying to put on street dance. This war that there's no technique. These dances were the answer to that. The Webo and a clubbing known as freestyle. Not freestyle music. That's what they called it in the early days. It was just freestyle, then clubbing, and then it became house. But I would do it in a speaker. I was just always doing the speaker. That's what, for me, what the club was about. I turn around, person does a flip. And his legs, his feet land straight on the chest. Anybody that's ever had that to them, that's almost someone's full body weight coming down. And I just fell straight to the floor. It didn't hurt. Luckily, I grew up with immediate family members that were martial artists. And I didn't study martial arts, but they had this little thing where they used to punch you in the chest when I was younger, or make me hit like metal on the wall. So it didn't hurt. Didn't even come close to hurting. So the body was pretty immune to that kind of pain. So I get straight up and I was like, yo, what are you doing? Like, cause I already comprehended the feeling of the house clubs. Like, you don't fight over anything stupid. But this person was from the hip hop clubs, and hip hop clubs at that time were very violent and very ignorant. Not dissing a person, but that's what was known in those colonized, created, low income, poor areas. Immediate fight. If you want space, you looking at a girl, and that girl's looking at you, and all these other stupid stuff that the colonizers put in their head, the colonized descendants. So I get up and the person's like, yo, F you. Yo, man, you know, let's battle. Because I guess he's trying to impress somebody around me. I don't know. I didn't know what was all that was about. But yeah, I already knew the protocol. If he wants to battle, then you battle. And I was already pissed because, like, you kicked me. He didn't even say, excuse me. And like, at least say, excuse me. He'll say, I'm sorry. So he started and I went back. I went on fire. The next week, true story. Already I had seen Keith Williams on the train. I'm not going to get deep into that story. Keith Boogie Williams, rest in peace, in peace. That day, he saw me on the train. Later that day, he's in the same club called The Tunnel. He sees me destroy this kid. And then the next week is when Keith asked me to join his group called K-Squared with Keith Lewis. And him, and then also Rasheem Spanky Johnson and Eon. Crazy how life works. After that, the name started getting passed around quickly because comprehend, I'm nowhere near in the colonized area that these people are from. I'm near Long Island. So coming into Manhattan took about almost 2 hours. So when I met Keith Williams, then of course knew everybody else. They all knew him. A little before that, I met Marjorie, rest in peace, but it wasn't really about dance, and I don't want to get into that. I said that on the timeline already. I used to walk in the club with girls on his arm, especially in this contest they had in the tunnel. I already knew Marjorie, so I didn't have no reason to introduce myself to Voodoo Ray, but we ended the meeting later anyway, after you saw me dance. I think it was the Red Zone. So it was interesting how I met everybody, but I would have never have met them if not for... Keith or Marjorie. then when I met Keith and I saw Marjorie, yeah, we already knew each other. But then it was Keith and then also Marjorie, who knew everybody. And the first time I saw Voodoo Ray, Voodoo Ray used to walk in the club with girls on his arm, especially in this contest they had in the tunnel. I already knew Marjorie, so I didn't have no reason to introduce myself to Voodoo Ray, but we ended the meeting later anyway, after you saw me dance. I think it was the Red Zone. So it's interesting how I met everybody. But I would have never have met them if not for... Keith or Marjorie. Never. Did I want to meet any of these people? Actually, no. I didn't really care because I had all my friends from Queens. You know, I'm on the border of Queens. And so this is the things that most dancers would deal with. Now I'm talking about dancers who just dance, who move a little bit. I don't know dancers like myself who are very versatile and they can do a long plethora of different dance styles. These are things you got to deal with. And what made me laugh about, I knew why most dancers were poor, was how they would act. And this is what I mean. So you can be working with a band or a singer or MC or rapper, and they'll come up on you as you're rehearsing. Oh, shoot, I'm gonna dance. Oh, yo, there go dances. And they start doing these weird dance movements. And you know, most dancers would be like, oh, shoot, go, and they say all that. But I was the type of person like, well, if I grabbed your guitar and played a flat note, and would you be cheering me that I'm a good guitarist? No. So those whack dance steps you just did, why should I be cheering you? That's the kind of dance I was, because that's the integrity. You don't see dancers going up to singers like, hey, check this note. Huh? No, you'd be like, wait, that's flat. Get out of here, kid. You can't sing. I mean, I'm talking about real singers, not the singers that love that auto-tune and they let it go by and y'all deal with it. That's up to, that's y'all. But the fact is, what I'm saying is, it's interesting how with dance, people can come up and do some of these weird movements and say crazy stuff like they were dancers. And a real dancer usually doesn't say anything. I was one of those dancers that was like, I see why you playing the piano. Like, please stay to the piano and excuse me, we got rehearsal. And they would look at me like, that's wrong. No, I'd be like, no, if I grabbed your piano if I grabbed your keyboard and sat down there and played a whole section of chords that made no sense, you would correct me. So why should I not correct you for those terrible dance steps you do that you might do in front of a girl in the club while she's drunk and you have to pay for a drink for her to get her to even like you? Why would I want to deal with that? See, dance is an art form too, just like singing, just like musicianship. It's an art form. You have to practice it. The way the media wants people to believe is like anybody can get up and dance. Just like lately they've been saying because of the auto-tune that if you can talk, you can sing. That's not true. These are gifts. We are given gifts. Groups of people are given gifts in order to support one another so they never have to do confusing and destructive things. That's why we're given gifts, because so we can support one another. Where confusion and destruction comes in is when you start to do work that is not attached to the gift you've been given. That's why it's important you support others with the same gift, because that builds a subsystem for y'all in this crazy, confusing, destructive one world system. But the more and more, it doesn't matter what the story is, because we all have the same story of people who didn't want us to do the gift that we've been given and blah, blah, blah. You fight and you stay there and you support people with the same gift, you will have a life that's financially stable.
It's time. See the land in my eyes. And the triangle of dreams.
I know people love true stories because honestly, truth is much crazier than fiction. Listen, now some of those videos y'all just saw, I'm not going to incriminate myself or anyone else. I'll just say the outline story of it. So one of the videos, I was in arguments with the record label heavily, like, okay, you know, not feeling the way these people are dressing. Now, reason why this is called testing the spirits in and around people is because they don't know, because most people think when you're this color, you start off in a poor neighborhood, and it's the same story because that story is very popular. I didn't start off that way. So in quote unquote, because y'all believe in race, and quote unquote, what y'all falsely taught to call white areas, rich white areas, there's a lot of nonsense that goes on that y'all don't believe that is very, very illegal. Y'all are taught to call it white collar crime, but it should be called something else. It should be called seances. So by the time I was in, I don't know, I would say by the time I was 9 or 10 years old, I wouldn't even say the grade, but 9 or 10 years old, I was already invited to quite a few nudist colonies and seeing a lot of things that I shouldn't have been seeing. But those people should have been arrested for inviting me at 9, 10 years old. But you're not going to arrest people who are judges, lawyers, doctors, professors, because that's the area that I was brought up in and went to school. And I'm laughing because a lot of y'all may not comprehend that. You can't report things to people who are the ones you report to. Let's say that again. You can't report things to people who are the ones you're supposed to report to. You can't. You can't report the ones doing the illegal acts that created the word illegal. So, with that being said, I was used to seeing nude bodies, so I just wanted to see what the people on set would do. What I mean by that is that only thing you can do when you come from upper middle class and go to school in rich and elite areas, you're not chasing money. It's not possible. So all you want to do is test the integrity if you're a decent person. Now, there's not many decent people in those areas. Not at all. Not at all. You can count on one hand how many decent people you meet in those kind of areas. But all you do, if you're a decent child, you just test things. You test the spirits. That's what it is. Not testing people, the spirits. Not the people, the spirits. So on this one set, I was asking the dancers, I don't like the wardrobe. And they were already complaining to me about the wardrobe. I said, okay, well, hey, I'll tell the stylist. Went to the stylist. The stylist was like, that's it. That's what the record label wants. I was like, oh, excuse me? That's not right. Came back, because I'm not going to give it away, the wardrobe was worse, more scandalous than it was before. So that's a test right there. So I told the dancers completely and boldly, even with the director there, we can end this right now. I don't need the money. And at the time, I wasn't even doing that financially well. I said, I don't need the money. We can end this right now, testing the integrity. We can end this right now, and we'll walk up the set. I don't care. I said this outwardly. What happens? Oh, no, Brian. The whispering. No, Brian, that's okay. I'm not going to say if it was male or female. That's okay. I need this money and all that. I was like, wow. So you don't mind looking like something that you don't want to look like? I said it again. I said it many times just to make sure they were hearing themselves. The next day, the wardrobe comes even more scandalous. Now, I'm just laughing. The reason I'm laughing because I don't come from those areas where I'm worried about that. Again, I've seen nudity, and on nudist colonies, not the greatest things happen that a child should see. So I'm seeing all this around 9-10 years old. I'm like, and murder in those kind of areas, y'all think poor areas do murders? No, the murders that they do in these richer areas are so much more demonic, because you actually know who does it, and most of it would be people who work in higher offices that judge people who do crimes. I guess that was said pretty well. So with that being said, you know, I was just looking at things like, okay, this is, oh, no wonder why. That was what I kept saying to myself. No wonder why poor people stay poor. They actually doing things consciously that they know is wrong. They're actually worse than the quote unquote people they say that oppress them, because the people that oppress them enjoy to do confusing, instructive acts. These poor people are doing confusing tricks and apps just to get that money that these oppressors have created. That's actually worse. Moving on. Rest in peace, Keith Williams. I'm not gonna tell the full story in this, but something very dirty happened to him in the entertainment business. That's why I came up with the word entertainment. And in one of the videos I choreographed, and I've choreographed many more than I'm putting up here, I ran into that situation. I can tell the situation because I'm not saying the artist. The situation was that Keith was going to choreograph something, and he was supposed to give the choreography over to another choreographer, and he did not want to do it and ended up getting sent home, and one of his friends put the choreography on another artist. I'm not saying it. That's as much as I'm going to say. That actually tried to happen to me, and instead I fought and wanted to see what would happen. Unfortunately, that's one of the big things that broke Keith's mentality and broke him down, and I was there all the way down to hospice and watched him die. And I wanted to feel what that was. Like, how could that break somebody down so bad? And I wanted to see what the remedy would be. And the remedy, of course, was I didn't have any idol worship for anybody. While some of the artists he worked for, he really wanted to work for. I never wanted to work with anyone. No one to me is that gifted that I praise them. I will say, hey, I praise the gift you've been given, but that's a praise to the creator for the gift you've been given, not you, the person. And I realized that was the thing that caught him, because if you praise people will always fail you in some way, because people have issues that this system gives them. But if you praise the creator for the gift someone gave you, you'll always be fine. What is going on with y'all productive people, gifted people? Why your timeline, the timelines that you're allowed to have, why are they full of other people? Come on, y'all. This is crazy. Like, there's so many, especially in the health community and the so-called conscious community and the dance community and so many different communities. Like, let's say health. I can see a junk food ad faster than I can see a health ad of something that's healthy, right? But then y'all can use the same buttons on the computer to promote every day like those companies do. Why don't y'all do it? A lot of y'all, like, I'm planning something and all that. There's no plan you're going to make that's going to make this one video that's going to go viral over the whole planet. No, everything has to work in daily promotions. That's why if y'all see my stories, I have daily promotion of productive, gifted people. That's the only way children can see a remedy. If children see productive things every once in a while, they're just going to go with the confusing and destructive because that's what's in their face all the time.
If you're helping things build that are confusing and destructive, then you can help things build that are productive. It's just putting that money there. If you have 20 sneakers in the closet, think about how much money you just spent for a company that you don't own. So now put 10 sneakers, the money of 10 sneakers, into a productive person or a productive job. And eventually that'll grow its own enterprise. It's not that hard.